Feed for Oshie, give it right back. Kuznetsov creeping towards the cage. Ovechkin fires and scores. Thunder upstairs.
Just work the puck with Oshie. He'll also get the secondary assist. But look at the way he lays it across. And that was a concern. Who's going to be able to throw it into the wheelhouse of Alex Ovechkin? Well, that's a simple...
Capitals buzzing on the power play. Ovechkin fires and scores. A sizzler past Williams' ear.
All over the place. But here you can't do anything. They set it up. And there's that slap shot.
What's going on, guys? Nate Kallen here. I've done a couple of stick handling sessions. I'm going to talk to you about some power play today. So the power play is one of the biggest things in today's game, especially in NHL, that teams will take advantage of and ultimately win games. The 5-on-5 play is extremely hard and difficult, extremely difficult to score in today's game. The goalies are so good, everyone's so good at defense. So the power play is where teams take advantage. Right now, in today's game, the 1-3-1 power play is probably the most popular. Washington, Ovechkin scores about 100 goals a year on this specific setup. The Lightning, many teams use this. And it comes down to three principles, really. Poise, patience, and possession. So each guy, they have the poise and the intelligence to make smart plays and wait out when a defender's stick is, let's say, like it's out here. He knows he can't go this way, so he passes it out to the wing here. They make smart, intelligent plays. So the 1-3-1, there's five guys on the ice, obviously, and each guy has their own specific role. I'd say I'm a defenseman, so I play up top here. I did it for like 3 years of my college career, and it's a role that it takes patience, especially to make the smart plays and not feed pucks just through a line of guys where there's no lane. So on the PK, teams are really good at blocking shots nowadays. And so this guy, he has to use his feet and his puck handling skills to make this guy believe he's either gonna pass, so he has this shooting lane. So this guy, he has options here, here. And when you're up here, you really don't wanna stay still. So this guy, he's always moving back and forth, looking for lanes, for passing lanes, for shooting lanes, and this movement up top helps this guy, or makes this defender go this way, this way, this way, always guessing and trying to block shots or block passing lanes. So if you use your deception and your puck handling skills to, let's say, fake a pass down to this guy will bite, this opens this lane, it opens shooting lanes, it opens a lane to this guy. So if this defender fakes a pass here, this point man fakes a pass here, and this defender bites, he moves it out to the middle here, and this pass here draws this guy here, which takes him off the winger here. Let's say he goes in, pass, shoot, and score. So there's many options and many different plays that teams run. I would say the most important thing to get these plays is to take advantage of the two-on-ones across the ice. So each time someone has the puck, let's say the puck's over here at this winger, it's a two-on-one between this guy and this guy and this defender, or this guy and this guy and this defender. So there's two-on-ones all over the ice that teams want to take advantage of. So that was a little basic recap of what the point man does. This guy, this winger, both wingers in this case want to get open for this defender for a pass or a 1T. This diagram's a little off, so this guy's a little out wide. Generally, he wants to be in line with the dots, so he has a good shooting lane and a nice close lane to the net. If he's out here, it's too far. The goalie will get there in time. So if you watch Ovi, Kucherov, all these guys with insane shots, they're lined up right with the dots, and their hips are open to this defender, ready for a one-timer shot into the net. I think Kucherov's over here at forehand. So same thing. He's on his forehand. He's opening up. Sticks over here, and he's just ready for this pass for a quick release or a fake down to this guy and a pass to the middle. I think Stamkos in the middle here, and he'll score. So these guys are always wanting to be ready to receive passes, be ready to make passes. They get the pass. They always know where they're going to pass, a step ahead of the game. So now going down to this guy, the net front guy, he wants to, when the puck's up here, he wants to be in front of the net, causing a screen for the goalie, so the goalie cannot see the puck. So this guy, he wants to have his stick in a ready position, ready for tips, ready for rebounds, getting body position on the goalie, and getting his stick out of lanes so he's always an option. So as a defender, I'm always looking for passes, shots, whatever, but also I'm looking for this guy to have his stick out here for a wide tip. So let's say the shot isn't necessarily directly, it's not there, directly in front. So I can shoot to the side here for this guy's stick, and it's a tip into the net. Now another thing that this guy is one of his jobs is to do is to be an option for these wingers when they don't have an option back to the point. So if there's a defender here, this point man comes down and he makes a pass to this guy and he has the puck. This defender is gonna take away this lane here, so that pass is not there back up to here. So this defender is gonna take this lane away and block this off so he can't pass here. This causes this winger to not have an option here and kind of be stranded. So one of the jobs of this guy in front is to come down low, be an option for this guy so he can have options and make good passes. And now when this guy has the puck, this defender comes out. Now it's another 2-on-1. Now this guy might fill this middle, this bumper might fill in for him. This guy might hit behind the net. Always looking for options and being ready for passes from your teammates. So the net front guy looking for tips, looking for screens, and looking to be an option for his teammates. Now the bumper, which is the guy in the middle, his job is pretty much to be a distraction for these defenders. So this guy in the middle, he just wants to draw people to him so these guys on the outside can have options. So if I'm on the point and let's say I get the guy, this defender to bite a certain direction, I move it out to here, I move it into the middle. All four defenders, it's hard, like playing PK, it's hard to know whose guy this actually is because he's in such a quiet area, right? So many times it happens when both these defenders come out and play this guy. So they're both here, they're both lined up on him. That opens up this guy down low for a quick pass and shot. It opens up the point man because everyone is kind of running around trying to find their man, and this guy is just lost, which is really good on the power play for this bumper guy. So this guy generally makes quick one-touch plays. He never really holds on to it too long because if he holds on to it too long, that these guys will be right on him and force him to cough it up. So it's generally, if it passes here, it's a quick one-touch out, or it's a quick one-touch here, or it's a quick catch on the backhand shot into the front, and in the net. So for this guy, it's really making quick, smart plays, and he's always a step ahead. So when he gets the puck, he knows exactly where he's gonna go every time. So that's a basic overview of the 1-3-1 power play.
Atlanta Thrashers scoring twice against Washington. Has been quieted tonight. Backstrom hooks off. Rivera, who will he choose? Ovechkin to fire, Montoya the save. Backstrom tees it up for Carlson. Nicklaus feeds to Ribeiro. Backstrom one more time. Carlson, Ovechkin, he scores.